Hi everyone, I'm going to show you how you can easily enter audio into slides with the bonus of how it can also be shared in Google Classroom. The easiest tool I find for this is here, online-voice-recorder.com. You simply go to this site, click the record button, and start speaking. Good morning everyone, it's great to see you, or at least sort of see you. Today I would like you to read for 20 minutes. Do the math sheet, and watch the video on photosynthesis and answer the questions and do the activity that follows. Have a great day and please reach out with questions. My office hours are from 1 to 2. To stop, I simply press the record button again and there you have it. This is my audio. I can trim it by dragging the ends. Unfortunately, I can't trim anything in the middle. Now I click save. And when I save, it will download automatically to my device. Now, you're going to need to know where it downloads to. In most cases, it's going to be a download file. Once I've done that, I'm going to go over to my Google Drive. And from here, I'm going to look for a folder that I've created called Audio Recordings. Now, this step is completely optional. You don't need to create a folder that says audio recordings. I just like to have all of mine in the same place. From here, I am going to open that file and I'm going to go to New and File Upload. File I just recorded on Online Voice Recorder. And there it is in my downloads folder, and I can tell it was done today. I click it and I say open. At this point, this file will be uploaded into my Google Drive. Okay, so here I have it. Now I'm going to go to my Google Slide. And I've prepared my slide already, and I want students to be able to just push a button right here. To do that, I go to Insert. I go down to audio and it will bring up my drive and show me the most recent audio files I have in reverse order, right? In reverse chronological order. So generally, if you've just recorded it, it's going to be that first one. I click it and click select. Now a little icon is going to appear on this slide. Sure enough, that looks like a speaker. And you can see this is what I recorded for students. I can move this around. And I can make it bigger so that it's really visible. You'll also notice if I click up here where it says Format Options, I get a whole option of things that I can do with this. And the audio playback is the thing that's probably the most important. So you can have something play automatically when you arrive on this slide or when the student opens this slide. Okay? You can put the volume to half if, let's say, you just want to have ambient music in the background. And you can loop the audio again and again, and you can make it stop when you change slides. This one is pretty cool because if you don't do that, whatever you're saying will continue to say, so that audio will continue to play even if someone navigates away from the slide. Okay, that's the first thing. Now let's talk about the bonus of Classroom. Say I just want to leave that as a video. I don't want to create the an audio file in Classroom, and I don't want to create the slide at all. I can come in here. And I can say, here are today's instructions. Probably want to spell that right. I could at this point type in these instructions. I'm going to copy them from my slide. Format them a little. And then underneath, I can just say, add a file from my Google Drive. Or I could just add it if I still have it on my computer straight from there. But I'm going to go to Google Drive because I like everything housed in one place. And there's the file. I click add. And there it is. When I post it, they can listen to the file right here. It's that simple.